Chinchu, a vulnerable population inhabiting in the eastern ghats of Atmakur, Dornal, Ahmedabad plateau of Kurnool and Mahabubnagar districts in the eastern ghats of Nallamalai forest. In the year 1975, the government of India has given them Pimpu tribal status. Very little is known about the history of the Chinchus. The epics, Manusmriti and other popular stories reveal that the Chinchus are the first dwellers of Andhra region much earlier than the Dravidian stock. In the colonial period, many anthropologists has written ethnographic notes on the Chinchu tribe but not able to provide the ethnohistory of the Chinchus. Many scholars from Andhra Pradesh also done research on the Chinchus. Among them, the most important work done by Professor Hemendorf on the Chinchus jungle folk of the Deccan, and another work by Edgar Thurston on castes and tribes of southern India. The Chinchu claim their origin and relationship with Lord Mallikarjuna of Srisailam temple. The story goes like this. Once a man and his wife lived in a small hut at some distance from the temple of Srisailam. They had no children and worshipped Lord Mallikarjuna for children. The god granted them the wish with the condition that the girl born to them should be dedicated to him. After 9 months, the wife gave birth to a girl child and dedicated her to Lord Mallikarjuna. The girl at the age of 3 left her parents and began living under a tree. Because she lives under a chettu, that is called as a tree, she was called as Chanchita. She grew up into a beautiful damsel. One day Lord Mallikarjuna came across this damsel in the forest and both of them fell in love and got married. The children born to this couple are called Chinchus. Hence, descendants of a girl who lived under Chettu are called the Chinchus. The Chinchus are dark complexioned and mostly short and slender in physical structure, and their hair also occur with a scant growth of hair on face and body. They are usually strong, evenly proportionated and well built, and have a very good stamina for trekking great distances in the forest. Chinchu speak a corrupt form of Telugu language. Professor Hemendorf believes that the language spoken by the Chinchus is not their original dialect because some of the words they use do not belong to Telugu language but to their original language, which they have forgotten long back. The Chinchu villages are called as Gudam. The Gudams where Chinchus inhabit are at the hilltop or at the foothills of the Nallamalai forest. The Chinchus always live in exclusive settlements of their own. The houses are scattered and there won't be any streets in the Gudams, which you can observe here. The houses are scattered from one house to another house. It will be 200 to 300 meters. You can see here. And they have the territorial division of other houses, which they have made with the bamboo compound walls. And there won't be any streets in the village. From one house to another house, it will take minimum 5 to 10 minutes to reach. The Chinchu never build their houses in the company of either the other tribals or non-tribal groups. The Gudams are homogeneous, exclusively inhabited by the Chinchu people. A typical house of a Chinchu is in square or circular or rectangular single room with bamboo split walls supported with bamboos. The roof is thatched and covered by locally available dabba grass. All other supporting structure is made of bamboo collected from the forest. The roof slopes down to front and back side of the house. Usually the roof is further extended on one side of the house to form a small veranda also sometimes. The house has no windows except one entrance at the front. It appears that the low roofs without any ventilation are for protecting themselves from cold winds during winter season and to avoid damage to bamboo walls due to rains. The Chenchu divide their house into two portions. One portion, that is one corner of the house, they will cook the food, and another corner they will be using for the dwelling. This is the typical house of the Chenchus which you are observing here. The roof is fully covered with the grass and bamboos, and the walls are made with the bamboo splits, which you can see here. Inside the house, one corner we have the kitchen, and another corner they are the dwelling place. This is the way of life they are living. The circular house is one room house. Within that circular house, they will be cooking and also they are dwelling. Very few houses has got the solar power for their lighting. And you can observe here, in the Bairluti Gudam and also in Pacheru, we observed that very few houses have the doors. Almost all the houses does not have the doors at all. Which you can observe here, the bamboo splits, how they have made. And women also participate in the construction of the houses. Which you can hear, the house construction is made with the bamboo sticks. And how a woman is also participating in the construction of the house. Both men and women share equally the economy and also the labor. The construction of the house takes minimum 20 to 30 days. All the members of the family and also their clan members will help in construction of the house. In Pacheru, we have 92 households. All the households are thatched huts. There is no concrete built house. The Chenchu villages, which are situated away from the forest region, are having the concrete houses. You can observe here, this is the Bairluti Gudam and Nagaluti Gudam have the concrete houses constructed under the scheme of Indira Awas. The Bairluti Gudam and the Nagaluti Gudam have the concrete houses, but none of the houses are in living condition. You can observe here, these houses are constructed, but they are of no use. At the side of these concrete houses, they have their own thatched huts. They say that the houses are not in good condition for their living. And during rainy season, almost all the water is coming inside the house. That is why we have our own indigenous houses. This is the Bairluti Gudam. You can see here the water tank, but it is never filled with the water. From the construction period till to date, they never pumped the water to the tank. And it is not at all functioning. For our water resources, still depending on our traditional way of collecting the water from the ponds and the wells. About the Chenchu's dress, Dr. Varalakshmamma and Professor Janikiramaya mentions in their research article that the dress of the Chenchu men consists of a waist string, that is the molotadu, made of a twisted fiber and a small piece of lion cloth. This is called as goshpata. 5 or 6 inches to cover his private part. During winter, the Chenchus wrap their body with a cotton cloth, which is sometimes used as a headgear, that is turban. Some men possess 2 pieces of cloth for body and a turban. The access to modern market brought changes in dress and material culture. They now wear the dress that is being worn by the villagers and town people. In other words, now mostly one may not find a Chenchu with only a piece of lion cloth. The Chenchu's women have adopted the dress of the plain people. They wear a choli or a bodice covering the upper part of the body, a sari, and under the sari a short petticoat, a kind of petu. Old women do not wear choli but cover the body with folds of a sari. All women possess bangles. Most women have their ears pierced and wear small rings or studs of various metals in the lobes. And some have the nostrils perforated and wear nose studs, mette or toe rings, that is also a tali, a marriage locket, and a string of black beads is the symbol of married status. Plastic and silver ornaments are becoming popular among the younger generation. The concept of family has been found to exist since time immemorial and at all levels of culture. In Chenchu society, father is the head of the family. Descent is patrilineal or agnatic descent. The rule of residence is patrilocal. Nuclear families are predominant among the Chenchus. Neolocal residence is common. After marriage, all sons share the father's property equally, that is, male equigeniture exists. Monogamy is a rule, but polygamy is also observed occasionally. So one can notice polygynous families along with the monogamous families in the Chenchu society. Our eldest male member enjoys the authority. Full authority vests in the hands of male. Women have no decision-making power, but she is consulted by men while taking certain important decisions. Even though women contribute to family income, they have little or no control over family expenditure. Thus, decisions regarding the family affairs are taken by father or eldest member of the family in consultation with family members.
The entire Chenchu society is divided into number of inti perlu. That is, you can equate with the clan or with the gotras. So they won't marry within the clan. They have to marry outside the clan. Clan exogamy exists among these people. Marriage is strictly followed according to the inti peru. So there are certain inti perlu that belongs to brothers and sisters. They won't marry. That we can make as a parity. Within the parity, we have different inti perlu. So the entire society we can divide into number of parities, and from parities we can classify inti perlu. That is the social organization among these people exist. So marrying within the clan is strictly prohibited.
ఈ ఒకే గోత్రంలో సరి గోత్రంలో పెళ్లి చేయరు కదా
సరే గోత్రంలో చేయం సార్ వాళ్ళు
బయట గోత్రంలో పెళ్లి చేస్తారు
ఇప్పుడు మా చెంచులమే మేమే ఇవ్వరు
బాబా ఆయన జగడం వేస్తాడే
మాట్లాడతాడు
అట్లే ఉండాల
పులిచర్ల సార్
పులిచర్ల
పులిచర్ నేను అర్థి నా బిడ్డను వారికి ఇవ్వచ్చు వారి బిడ్డను నేను తీసుకోవచ్చు నా కొడుకు అట్లా మాకు ఇద్దరికి అయితే సరిపోతుంది మేమైతే ఇద్దరం అర్తి
అర్తి
కుడుంగా మా బిడ్డలను మాత్రానికి మేము చేసుకోం సార్
అంటే అర్తిలో అర్తి చేసుకునే దానికి లేదు
లేదు
ఇంకొక దాంట్లో చేసుకోవచ్చు
ఈ మూడు ఒకటే సార్ ఈ
కుడుంలోడు
అర్తి వాడు ఒకటే సార్
ఒకటేనా
ఒకటే వీళ్ళు వీళ్ళు ఉత్తరులు వారు సార్ వీళ్ళు కూడా మా బిడ్డను మేము వాళ్ళకి ఇస్తాము వాళ్ళ బిడ్డను మేము చేసుకుంటాం సార్ వాడు దాసరాడు సార్ భూమరాడు సార్ భూమరాడు తర్వాత కుడుమరాడు సార్ కుడుమరాడు తర్వాత అర్తువాడు సార్
అర్తువాడు
అర్తువాన్ తర్వాత నిమ్మలోడు
నిమ్మలోడు
నిమ్మలోడు ఉత్తూరువాడు
ఉత్తూరువాడు
ఉత్తూరువాడు పులిచర్లోడు
పులిచర్లోడు
చెవులోడు
చెవులోడు
దంసమోళ్ళు
దంసమోళ్ళు
గుల్లవాళ్ళు
గుల్లవాళ్ళు
అవును సార్ దాసరోడు
దాసరోడు
పిట్టవాళ్ళు
పిట్టోళ్ళు
చెవులోళ్ళు
చెవులోళ్ళు
తోకలోళ్ళు
తోకలోళ్ళు
అవును సార్ దంసమోళ్ళు
దంసమోళ్ళు
A woman is considered to have conceived when she misses her menstrual cycle. Delivery is always conducted inside the house. Chenchu won't observe any birth pollution and they do not have any separate name giving function. The eldest member of the family or the clan gives the name to the newborn baby on the fourth or fifth day of the birth.
అమ్మాయి పెద్దదవుతుంది, వయసుకు ఫస్ట్ టైం ముట్ట అవుతుంది కదా, ఇంటికి దూరం అవుతుంది కదా, దానికి ఏమైనా పేరు ఉంది? మీ పేర్లు ఏమంటారు?
పెద్ద మనిషి అంటారు సార్.
పెద్ద మనిషి అయింది,
సమర్థ అయింది అంటారు సార్.
సమర్థ అయింది, పెద్ద మనిషి లేదంటే సమర్థ
అయింది.
ది ఫస్ట్ ప్యూబర్టీ గర్ల్ ఈజ్ అలౌడ్ టు సిట్ అట్ వన్ కార్నర్ ఆఫ్ ది హౌస్ అండ్ షీ ఈజ్ నాట్ అలౌడ్ టు గో టు ది ఫారెస్ట్ ఆర్ టు వర్క్ స్టిల్ ది బ్లీడింగ్ స్టాప్స్ ఆన్ ది ఫిఫ్త్ ఆర్ ది సెవెంత్ డే they give a bath and new clothes to wear. They prefer cross-cousin marriages. Sister's daughter is also a potential mate for marriage. The payment of bride price exists among the Chanchus and it is called as Oli. They pay 20 to 80 rupees as a bride price to the bride's father. The marriage ceremony is called Palli. The rules of exogamy, that is kulam, is followed in all types of marriages. Marriage by negotiation or arranged marriage and marriage by elopement are the common forms of marriage among the Chanchu. Divorce is allowed and they are allowed to marry according to their choice. Widow and widower remarriage is allowed. The death is called as chavu. Each kulam has a separate area for burying or for cremation of the dead. They follow both cremation and burying according to the desire of the family members of the deceased. The pollution lasts for 15 days. On the third day, they perform a small obsequies and on the fifth day, they perform petta dinam. On that day, the deceased family members provide non-vegetarian food to all the family members and the relatives. The Chanchu men and women gather different type of foods from forests. From the forest almost every day, men and women including children collect roots, tubers and leaves. Chanchus naturally use bow and arrow, net and rat trap or bird traps for catching the animals and birds. The average bow is about 44 to 54 inches in length and is made out of a slightly flat and thick bamboo split of 2 to 2.5 inches of width, slightly tapering at both the ends. The life of string which is used in the bow will depend upon the quality of the string. The arrow which he uses for hunting varies from animal to animal. Broadly, there are three types of arrows that the Chanchu exercise for hunting. Gorkha or Potambu is an arrow which is used to hunt small birds, rats, squirrels, etc. The second type of arrow called Vilambu is a flattened one, especially used for hunting rabbits. The third one is the Ambu, is a sharp-pointed one with feathers on one eagle and arrow on the other. Chanchu follow individual hunting and gathering. Both elders and youngsters go to the forest in search of the birds and beehives. They hunt animals like sheep, squirrel, doves, pigs, deer, wild goat, duppulu, deer, porcupines and different kind of birds. Once the Chanchus were living happily in the forest, depending on the forest resources for their living. After declaring the Nallamala Hills as a forest resource and as a tiger national park, this declaration has brought several changes among the Chanchus. The impact of the tribal development programs and the migration of the plain people to the Chanchu areas brought several changes among the Chanchus. The impact of these activities so strong that they lost their traditional subsistence and the environment and facing a threat for their survival. Here you can observe, once they were the food gatherers and hunters, slowly depend on the forest resources. Now they are forced to change their occupation. Now many of them became agricultural laborers, forest laborers, and some of them adopted collection of the firewood from the forest. and selling in the local markets, which you can observe here. The dry wood they will collect from the forest and make them into bundles and sell these wood nearby market or on the national highway to the people who are required. So like this, the way of life of the Chanchus has changed. Here you can observe the dry wood selling on the highway. Some of the Chanchus have adopted the occupation of making artifacts from the bamboos. Here you can see this Chanchu man is preparing the sticks from the bamboo. The loss of forest and the restrictions to enter into the forest for food gathering and hunting changed their way of life. Some of the Chanchus had adopted domestication of the animals. Here you can see the buffaloes they are rearing and collecting the milk and selling the milk in the local market. Here these buffaloes they are getting from the Dokra scheme, which is functioning well in Bairloti Gudem.
ఏం పేర్లు గ్రూపుల పేరు ఏమని తెలుసా మీ గ్రూప్ పేరు ఏంటి ఆదిలక్ష్మి గ్రూప్ కనకదుర్గ గ్రూప్ మీదమ్మా అంకాలమ్మ గ్రూప్ సరస్వతి గ్రూప్ దే హావ్ ఫైవ్ గ్రూప్స్ ఇన్ దిస్ విలేజ్ ఫంక్షనింగ్ ఫర్ డోక్రా ఫర్ ది సెల్ఫ్ హెల్ప్ గ్రూప్స్ దిస్ ఇస్ వన్ ఆఫ్ ది ఇంపార్టెంట్ వన్ ఐ వాంటెడ్ టు మెన్షన్ హియర్ Under the Dokra scheme, they have opened five groups, which we have given the names. Under the five groups, they have started and functioning very well. They have opened the bank accounts. When it was, and under the scheme, they have paid the money. And the bank has also given 10,000 rupees for each individual. They have purchased the cows. Avule kada konindi? Mekal konukunnaru. They purchased the goats. But the goats not survived. All of them are, because of the high altitude, they died. With different kind of diseases. After the death, they were not able to repay the amount to them. See, here I wanted to inform the policy makers and the planners. These are the vulnerable population. We call as a primitive tribes. How one can expect that can pay the 10,000 rupees to the bank again? It is impossible for them. And on average, they are earning only 8 to 10 rupees per head per day, not more than that. 10,000 rupees is a very big amount for them. So I suggest the government of India and the tribal affairs and the ministry, if you are really interested to develop and conserve this population, these people should be given free loan. The goats and the sheep, they are get infections and diseases. Rogam peru emma cheppinavu? Aavu mekalu kostundi. Gali. Gali kunta. That is the disease. Indigenous disease name is Gali kunta. That is affects the goats. Affects the. That is why they don't want the goats and the sheep. They want the buffaloes. Buffaloes are for this conditions of environment. It is suitable. So if they will give the buffaloes, they extract the milk, and milk from the milk they will butter extraction, and they can sell the butter. And they are living far away interior jungle, they cannot sell the milk. So they can sell the butter, extract the butter, like todas they wanted to do a pastoralistic way of life. So that is why I request every household, every family, should be given a buffalo at free of cost for these people for their substance of economy.
System, they have their own individual political system. The political system is called as panchayat. In this panchayat, Pedda Manishi is the head of the village and he is assisted by Kotakadu. Kotakadu. Atharvati Ngopane Talari. Talari is the, these are the three people. Pedda Manishi, Kotakadu, Talari. These are the three people who controls the entire political situation in this Chanchu villages. So dintlo panchayatulu ememi meeru chestaru cheppandi koncham
sir. Memu tagada panchayat aitaremo tagada panchayat chestam ledu mari pilla pilloodiki nachakunda ఏదైనా
విడిపోవాలంటే
ఆ పంచాయతీ చేస్తాం. లేదు పిల్లోడు పిల్లకు నచ్చకుండా, పిల్లకు నచ్చి పిల్లోడు నచ్చకపోయినాడు, పిల్లోడికి నచ్చి పిల్లకు నచ్చకపోయింది అనుకో, వాళ్ళకు ఆ పంచాయతీ చేస్తాం. పంచాయతీ చేసి దాన్ని సరి చేయడమా, లేకపోతే వాళ్ళని
సపోజ్ ఇప్పుడు ఇద్దరికి ఒకరు ఇంకో కుటుంబానికి ఇంకొకరు జగడాలు అయింది, అది కూడా తీరుస్తారు?
అది కూడా తీరుస్తాం సార్.
పొడుచుకునేది సంపుకునేది అవంతా ఏం లేదు కదా?
అదంతా ఏం లేదు సార్. అంత పెద్దగా లేదు సార్. పొడుచుకునేది
సార్, అది బాగా కొట్టుకునేది అవన్నీ కూడా తీరుస్తారు కదా?
అది కూడా తీరుస్తాం సార్.
సో ఆల్ ది కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ డిస్ప్యూట్స్ దే విల్ సెటిల్, జనరలీ దే ఓంట్ గో ఫర్ పోలీస్ స్టేషన్, మోస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ది కేసెస్ దే విల్ బి డెల్ట్ ఇన్ ది పంచాయత్ ఓన్లీ. డైవర్స్, రీమ్యారేజ్ అండ్ విడో రీమ్యారేజ్ అండ్ ఆల్సో ది స్మాల్ కోరల్స్, పెట్టి కోరల్స్, కోరల్స్ విచ్ అరైజెస్ ఇన్ ది ఫారెస్ట్, మ్యారేజ్, ఎలోప్మెంట్, ఆల్ దీస్ కేసెస్ they will dispose among themselves by the panchayat people.
The Chenchus were once animists and totemists with their belief system around trees, spirits and totemic objectives. The Chenchu worship village deities such as Chenchu Devata, Peddamma, Polaramma, Ankalamma, Sunkamma, Maramma, Mantalamma, నాగలూటి, పాములేటి, ఓగులేశ్వర స్వామి, పెద్దన్న, పోతురాజు అండ్ మల్లమ్మ బాయన్న యాజ్ బెనివలెంట్ గాడ్స్. ది చెంచు కన్సిడర్ గరేలమాయ్ సామ యాజ్ అన్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ డైటీ ఫర్ దర్ వర్షిప్. ది డైటీ రూల్స్ ఓవర్ మెనీ థింగ్స్ కనెక్టెడ్ విత్ ది జంగల్ లైఫ్, ఈవెన్ ది బ్లాజమింగ్ ఆఫ్ ఫ్లవర్స్ అండ్ బర్గోయింగ్ ఆఫ్ ఫ్రూట్స్. Therefore, the first produce is offered to her. With a simple prayer, she is also called upon to watch when they climb up trees or rocks to gather fruits and honey. There are no particular shrines for many deities. Female deities need animal sacrifice. Chenchu Devata is their traditional god. They also worship Naga Devata, that is snake god. Chenchu also worships tree gods such as Aruta and Marguza trees. Gangamma is considered as the water deity. While crossing water, they offer a prayer to her. They give an offering to Gangamma when they perform the child's tonsure ceremony. The impact of Hinduism can be observed among the Chenchus, which we can observe here. They started worshipping the Hindu gods, that is Sri Rama and Lord Narasimha of Simhachalam. In Bailuti Gautam, they have constructed a temple for the Sri Rama temple, which you are observing here. This is the Rama, Lakshmana and Sita. They celebrate Sri Rama Navami and Sivaratri festival like other Hindu people will be performing. Both men and women are given importance in religious worshipping. Only during the menstrual period, the woman is not allowed to perform the pujas, which you can observe here. The girl officiates as a temple priest in this Bairlitigudam Sri Rama temple. All the families of Bairlitigudam contribute equally for worshipping Lord Sri Rama. The declaration of Naramala Hills as a reserve forest and National Tiger Park had a direct impact on the livelihoods of the Chenchus. The Chenchus who are inhabiting inside the Tiger Reserve are forced to move to the foothills of the Naramala Hills. The Chenchus living in the Pettacheru Gudam area are the worst affected. Rehabilitation was not done properly. According to the Chenchu elders, many of them died because they were not able to adapt to the new environment.
Then this could be rehabilitated chesnam sir antaru ledu
le sir akada me ee gudam molame mood tegalinam sir మూడు తెగలు ఒకటి అమలాపురంలో చేరింది, ఒకటి పెచ్చేర్లో చేరింది, ఇంకా కొంతమంది ఏమో అక్కడక్కడ చుట్టాలైన దగ్గర పోయినారు సార్.
ఇప్పుడు అందరూ వాపసు వచ్చేసినారా?
అందరూ
రాలేదు కదా,
అందరు
600 మంది ఉన్నామని చెప్తున్నారు కదా. ఇప్పుడు ఎంతమంది ఉన్నారు?
మేము ఇక్కడ ఉండేది 92 ఉన్నాయి సార్.
92 మంది, 100 మంది అనుకోయమే.
అవును సార్.
ఇంకా 500 మంది ఆడిపోయినారు.
మా వాళ్ళు 100 మంది ఫస్ట్ చచ్చిపోయినారు సార్.
వంద మంది
చనిపోయారు. ఇంకా ఆ భయం ఫస్ట్ తీసుకుపోయి టౌన్ లో వదలడం అదే సార్ మా వాళ్ళకి. ఆ టౌన్ అనేది పడదు
చూడండి వాళ్ళు. ఆడ పార తెగినారు గానీ 2.5 ఎకర్ ఇచ్చినారు అన్నారు. ఆ 2.5 ఎకర్ ఇచ్చింది కూడా సరిగా లేదు, సరిగా వర్క్ కూడా చీపియలేదు.
ఇది
ఇప్పుడు కూడా ఆ పరిచి తిట్టి ఇప్పుడు కూడా అట్లా ఉంది సార్. ఆడ
30 సంవత్సరాలు దగ్గర అవుతుంది సార్.
దగ్గర ఇప్పుడు 30 సంవత్సరాలు నువ్వే చూపించలే ఇంత మటుకు. సరిగా ఇది నీ పొలము, ఇది పట్ట నీది అని చెప్పి కూడా ఇయ్యలేదు సార్ ఇంత మటుకు. ఇంకేడ ఉంటారు మనుషులు, చెడుకు ఒకరే వెళ్ళిపోయినారు సార్ అంతా.
ప్రెసెంట్లీ ఐ ఆమ్ ఇన్ నల్లమలై ఫారెస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఆంధ్రప్రదేశ్ ఇన్ ది మిస్ట్ ఆఫ్ చెంచు అబొరిజినల్ పాపులేషన్ హూ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో కాల్డ్ ప్రిమిటివ్ ట్రైబ్స్ ఆర్ వల్నరబుల్ పాపులేషన్. They are facing difficult for their survival. It is becoming very difficult for them for their survival, future survival. They are facing different kind of problems. First one which I wanted to mention is economic problem. Economically, they are food gatherers, hunters and fishing society. They lost their traditional occupation because of the expansion of the forest policies. Now they are facing the problem of the survival. They have no doubt going for minor forest produce collection, food gathering, hunting has totally gone. Only minor forest roots, tubers they are collecting, medicinal plants they are collecting and selling in the cooperative society and surviving. Their income generation has gone down totally. Now on average you can say 10 to 12 rupees they are earning per day. The per capita income is almost negligible for their substance of living. Here which I want to mention here is they have to go for daily for the forest for food gathering, otherwise they cannot survive. Many of them are getting job through NRGS scheme for 100 days only. Afterwards they are not able to get any income generation schemes. Of course these women, they have the 4 Dokra self help groups, 5 self help groups these women formulated, but they have generated the money and got the loan of the goats, but all the goats died because of certain diseases and they are not able to pay back the money, and the self help group has been closed. So that is the empowerment has generation has been totally lost for the women. For the sustainability, she has Ankamma. Her name is Ankamma. She has 8 goats. So 8 goats suddenly died because of the disease which she has got. There is no substitute for her income generation. She is struggling very hard for her survival. The money which she has saved through help self group has also lost. Now she is on the street and she is not able to get any income generation. I request the government should help her to compensate. She should be provided 8 goats again by free of cost, and also the Dokra schemes should be considered immediately. All the people, those who have lost the goats, they should be replaced. Many of them are requested, they don't want the goats because of their subsistence is very poor and the climate is totally different. That is why they are requesting cows and buffaloes. I request the government should give each family, 92 families are there, each family a cow or a buffalo, so that they are telling she wanted to extract the butter from it, and butter she will sell and she can able to live happily. That is the request which the Aboriginal population, the vulnerable population, the women are requesting. Here they have the elementary school from 1st standard to 5th standard. 0 to 5th standard. So in this school, they are providing midday meals.
దీస్ పీపుల్ రిక్వెస్ట్ రెసిడెన్షియల్ హాస్టల్ షుడ్ బి ప్రొవైడెడ్ ఫర్ దీస్ పీపుల్ హియర్ 38 స్టూడెంట్స్ ఆర్ దేర్ దే ఆర్ వెరీ మచ్ సాటిస్ఫైడ్ విత్ ది ఫంక్షనింగ్ ఆఫ్ ది స్కూల్ హియర్ ఇన్ పెచ్చెరువు ఇన్ బైర్లూటిగూడెం ఇంకొక ఊరు పేరేంటి
బైర్లూటి నాగలూటి శ్రీశైలం
నాగలూటి అండ్ శ్రీశైలం దే ఆర్ గోయింగ్ బట్ ఓన్లీ ఫర్ హయ్యర్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ దే ఆర్ నాట్ ఏబుల్ టు గెట్ దిస్ ఫుల్ సపోర్ట్ బికాస్ ఇట్ ఇన్వాల్వ్స్ ఫైనాన్షియల్ సర్వీస్ వన్స్ దే పాస్ ది 10th స్టాండర్డ్ దే ఆర్ రిక్వెస్టింగ్ దట్ ది స్టూడెంట్స్ దోస్ హు పాస్ 10th స్టాండర్డ్ దే షుడ్ బి టేకెన్ కేర్ బై ది గవర్నమెంట్ ఆఫ్ ఇండియా ఇట్ ఈస్ అ జెన్యూన్ రిక్వెస్ట్ దే ఆర్ మేకింగ్ ది వల్నరబుల్ పాపులేషన్ నాట్ ఓన్లీ దీస్ చెంచూస్ ఇన్ 75 ప్రిమిటివ్ ట్రైబ్స్ ఆల్ ఆర్ ఫేసింగ్ ది సేమ్ ప్రాబ్లమ్ so once they pass 10th standard they should be taken care by the government of india by the ministry of tribal affairs 100% they have to take to the students into the tribal universities in the tribal university they should be given 100% education whatever kind course they want they should be given the higher education then only those people who pass the examination they can change this society otherwise the food gatherers and hunting societies it is impossible until and unless from grassroots level we have to educate them once they get educated like kotas todas maramnagas all these people are well educated and the primitive tribes they have developed they have their own subsistence now they are now the dependence on the government has been changed they have the individual economic subsistence they have developed because of education until unless we are not going for education it is very difficult for these vulnerable population to develop so they have the employment generation through NRGA national rural employment generation scheme it is functioning dabbu meeku sakramanga vachertunda vallu correct ga istharu
correct ga istharu
and they are getting the wages also without any problem it is a wonderful it is functioning here that is what I came to know NRGA is functioning well and also they are getting their wages regularly without any delay mahatma idi indira awaz ani inglu kattichinaru meek emana kattichinara
maake em kattilesu
there is no inglu kosam ye saukaryam cheyaledu
cheyaledu
inga gudisillane undaru
inga gudisillane undaru sir ma tharadu ma taadalu
chustava
daval kani
see here which you have observed the topography of the village which I will be showing you here in this topography we can observe most of that thatched huts only in Indira Awas or any other scheme sub plan scheme not even a single house has been constructed in this region they want inglu kavalana meeku
kavala sir
so they all the people ఎన్ని ఇండ్లు ఉన్నాయి మొత్తం ఇది ఊర్లో ఎన్ని ఇండ్లు వస్తాయి మొత్తం
92
ఇన్ దిస్ విలేజ్ 92 హౌస్ హోల్డ్స్ ఆర్ దేర్ ఆల్ ది హౌస్ హోల్డ్స్ షుడ్ బి ప్రొవైడెడ్ ఏ పక్కా హౌసెస్ కాంక్రీట్ హౌసెస్ సో ఇన్ ఇందిరా ఆవాజ్ ఆల్సో డోంట్ గివ్ ది మనీ డబ్బు మీ చేతికి ఇచ్చేది ఇల్లు కట్టించేయమంటాం డబ్బిస్తే సరిపోతుందా సో దే డోంట్ వాంట్ ది మనీ బి పేడ్ ఇన్స్టాల్మెంట్స్ అకార్డింగ్ టు ద రిక్వైర్మెంట్ you construct the house with a good contractor and proportionate cement and materials you give them the house that is the requirement they are making they don't want to the money in installment paying by the checks because they had the enough experiences in the plain people that is living in the plain areas of the Chanchus that is why the government itself has to construct good houses for them in this region they are requesting 5 kilometers they have to walk it is a kacha road they want a metal road for this village to be connected with a metal road and also they want the electricity there is no electricity facility here but the forest department has provided recently the solar lights in the streets urlo kuda ichara me solar lights I think they have given pan chestunnaru
kada pan chestunnaru
they have given the solar lights and it is functioning well they are satisfied with the provision of the electricity by the forest department
enti
dargayya made by Mr. Dargayya is they have a dug well which provides water and sufficient water is there in that dug well but Taking the water is becoming a difficulty because it going in deep, more than 25 meters depth. So old people and small kids, it is difficult to get.
The tiled house which you are observing behind me is the oldest building constructed during colonial period by the British administrators. The well which you are observing here is also dug during the colonial period. Still the Chanchus are using the well water for the drinking purpose. You can observe the depth of the well, how much deep it is. During the summer periods, the depth of the water level goes down.
By drawing the water, it is getting polluted. He is requesting that overhead tank should be constructed here and the water should be pumped to the overhead tank, and she wants a tap in her house. Because so this is the basic requirement requested by many of the tribes in India, exclusively primitive tribes. Water facilities should be made for this village by construction of a overhead tank, and also tap provisions should be made. Ankamma, she knows the stitching. She is asking, she wanted to have a sewing machine to be provided, and also she wanted to teach these ladies, Ikrama, these ladies stitching, so that they can able to do the tailoring and earn their subsistence. So it is a wonderful suggestion Ankamma is requesting here for the empowerment of the women. We should go for this type of occupations, especially sewing, nursing and embroidering. All these things, you know, they empower the women. And she is interested to run that center for teaching their own people how to sew and embroidering. I think I request the young girls who are interested, they should be provided sewing machine for learning.
సౌకర్యం ఏం లేదు సార్. ఇప్పుడు ఇండ్లు, మాకు ఇండ్లే చాలా ప్రాబ్లమ్. మాకు ఇండ్లు, రోడ్డు, కరెంటు. మాకు ఈ మూడు స్థాయిలో అయితే
మంట పెద్దలు వేసుకున్న గాని రోడ్డు అయితే బాగుంటుంది.
పొలం లేదు, తీర పెద్ద 2 ఎకరాలు అన్నారు. ఆ 2 ఎకరాలు కూడా ఇయ్యాల రేపు అనే తొలగని దాని ఇడు ఉందమ్మా, నీది ఇడు ఉంది, వేసుకుంటావా నువ్వు, గుర్తొకించుకుంటావా
అని
కోరుకుంటావా అని చెప్పటోళ్ళు ఎవరు లేరు సార్.
By and large, children of nature, their lifestyle being conditioned by their ecosystem, education can aid the primitive tribes by supplementing their knowledge about their environment. By providing logical and scientific explanations for external phenomena which fall within the ken. After independence, the government of India and the state government made special efforts to spread education among the tribal children. For the education of the Chanchus, in Bailuti Gudam, the government of India and the state government established a co-educational school with hostel facilities. But these schools are not functioning to the satisfactory. Here you can observe the Bailuti Gudam, the school and the PSC center with hostel. But they are not up to the mark serving the Chanchu children. Educational gaps among the Chanchu can be viewed as due to differences in the provision of educational facilities, socio-economic status of the parents, lack of motivation, isolation of villages, lack of communication and language. The isolation of the Chanchus affects their education in many ways. The disadvantaged Chanchu children are more present-oriented and they have vague and indefinite notions about the future and little sense of pattern and regularity. This is the dining hall for the Bailuti Gudam school, which you are observing here is a residential school. For the lunch, they are giving rice, curry and buttermilk with an egg. This is the routine food which they will be getting during lunch time. Here, along with the Chanchu children, the other caste people also residing in the hostel, which is a disadvantage for many of the Chanchu children. They were not able to coexist along with the non-tribal children. The Chenchu children are not able to associate with the other caste and tribal children in the classrooms. In Bairoti Gudam, 50% of the seats are given to the Chenchu children and 50% of the seats are given to the outsiders, that is non-tribals and other caste people. It is becoming very difficult for the Chenchus to cope up with other students. The residential school is co-education. The Chenchu female children drop out when they reach the puberty age. Most of the female children drop out after the 5th standard. It is necessary to establish Chenchu residential schools exclusively for boys and girls separately. Active based learning teaching programs should be introduced in these schools. An integrated Chenchu tribal residential school from 8th to 12th standard should be established for all the Chenchu children of Nallamala Hills.
మా పిల్లలకు ఎవరు చదువు చెప్తున్నారు సార్? మా పిల్లల మీ పిల్లలకు చదువు మీ పిల్లలకు చెప్పినట్టు మా పిల్లలకు చెప్తే మా పిల్లలు ఎందుకు నేర్చుకోరు సార్? మీ పిల్లలకైతే మీ పిల్లలు ఎందుకు నేర్చుకుంటారు? మా పిల్లలు ఎందుకు నేర్చుకోకుండారు? మేము కూడా ఒక పంతలే కొట్టి చదువు నేర్పుతాడనే మాకు కూడా ఆశ
అనిపించింది.
కానీ మా పిల్లలకు ఏం చదువు ఉందో, కానీ మా పిల్లలకు చదువు చెప్పాలంటే మీ గవర్నమెంట్ కూడా ఇబ్బందే. మా పిల్లలు కలెక్టర్లు అయ్యి మా వాళ్ళు పెద్దలు పెద్దగా పెద్దగేతారని అందుకోసమని మా పిల్లలకు చదువు చెప్పాలంటే కూడా బాధే సార్.
ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ విలేజ్
ఫోర్త్ సెక్షన్
ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ విలేజ్ 16 పీపుల్ హ్యాస్ గాట్ ది జాబ్ ఇన్ ది ఫారెస్ట్ డిపార్ట్మెంట్ అండ్ దే ఆర్ గెటింగ్ ది మంత్లీ శాలరీ. ఏం పొజిషన్ లో ఉన్నారు మీరంతా? టైగర్ ట్రాకర్స్ అండ్ ఫారెస్ట్ ప్రొటెక్షన్ వాచర్స్. 16 పీపుల్ హాస్ గాట్ అపాయింట్మెంట్ అండ్ ఈస్ టెల్లింగ్ దట్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ దట్ జాబ్ దర్ సస్టైనబిలిటీ, దర్ లివ్లీహుడ్ అండ్ దర్ వే ఆఫ్ లైఫ్ ఈస్ చేంజింగ్ ర్యాపిడ్లీ అండ్ దర్ చిల్డ్రన్ ఆర్ గెటింగ్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ అండ్ ఈ కెన్ ఏబుల్ టు టేక్ కేర్ ఆఫ్ హిస్ ఫ్యామిలీ.
Sir, can you find after appointment of these people as a tiger trackers, is there any development in the conservation of the tigers and the flora and fauna?
Yes sir, yes sir. Daily their duty is to daily they have to check all pathways, trails and pathways of the wild animals. And the tiger population also has been increased.
Wonderful.
And last year, every year, NTCA, National Tiger Conservation Authority, they give awards on different aspects like best park management. For the last year, our NSTR, Northern Parks Reserve, certainly has got the best human resource awards.
Okay.
Among 42 tiger reserves
in the country. In the India.
In the country, we got the best human resource management,
sir,
because of all their efforts.
Their efforts. Their efforts. This is a wonderful idea which has been implemented in the Nallamala Hills by the Forest Department, appointing a tiger tracker. In the same way, the Gir National Park also, who can appoint the primitive tribes inhabiting in that region as a lion trackers or the forest protectors. 42 conservation parks are there. I think almost all the conservation tiger parks we have the primitive tribes. I request the policy makers and decision makers of Government of India to look into these aspects, to consider to appoint the same tribes, those who are inhabiting in that region, for conservation of the forest wildlife and also the flora and fauna, then it will be successful. Not only conservation of the forest, the tribals who are inhabited, they will also be sustained, they can live for longer life.
Chenchu boys who are gone for higher education, in the sense he is in a class lo navu
intermediate
second year. Pair enti?
Nagaraj.
Nagaraj, he is the boy who is graduating now. Ye pair em babu?
Nagaraj sir. Pulicherla Nagaraj. Pulicherla Nagaraj.
Pulicherla Nagaraj. ఏ చదువుతున్న బీకామ్?
సెకండ్
ఇయర్.
సెకండ్ ఇయర్ సార్.
ఫైనల్ ఇయర్. సో దీస్ ఆర్ ది టూ బాయ్స్ సో ఫార్ ఐ హావ్ సీన్ అమాంగ్ ది చెంచోస్. ఇఫ్ దీస్ టూ బాయ్స్ వర్ గివెన్ ఆపర్చునిటీ టు గో ఫర్ హైయర్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్
ఇంకా పైకి ఎంకామ్ అంత చదువుతావా? పైకి పోవాలని ఆశ ఉంది. సో హీఈస్ హ్యావింగ్ ది అంబిషన్ టు గో ఫర్ హైయర్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ అప్ టు ఎంకామ్ అండ్ ఆల్సో డూ రీసెర్చ్. దట్ ఈస్ హీస్ అంబిషన్. నువ్వేం చేయాలనుంది? నీకేం చదవాలనుంది? పైకి వెళ్ళి ఏం కావాలనుంది? కలెక్టర్ కావాలండి. సీ దిస్ ఇస్ ది అంబిషన్ ఆఫ్ ది చెంచు. యూ కాల్ యాజ్ ఎ వల్నరబుల్ పాపులేషన్ ఇన్హాబిటింగ్ ఇన్ దిస్ రీజియన్. హిజ్ అబ్జెక్టివ్ హీ వాంటెడ్ టు బికమ్ ఎ కలెక్టర్. ఐ థింక్ ది పాలసీ మేకర్స్, ది డెసిషన్ మేకర్స్, ది పీపుల్ ఆఫ్ ఇండియా షుడ్ ఫుల్ఫిల్ హిస్ డిజైర్. హీఈస్ ఎ సిటిజన్ ఆఫ్ ఇండియా, బిలాంగ్ టు దిస్ మదర్ ఎర్త్, అండ్ డినయింగ్ హీస్ రైట్స్ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో నాట్ యాక్సెప్టబుల్. To become a collector and serve for his nation and also exclusively for this region as a integrated tribal development project officer in the cadre of IAS is ambition. So the government of India should come forward to take such a type of people into the universities personally and to spend for their expenses, hostel facilities, everything. And to go make them to fulfill with their objectives, that is the main intention of this Man in Search of Man series. The first time the Chanchu, who are vulnerable population living in the Nallamala Hills, going for a graduation and completing the intermediate is a great achievement. It is not a small thing. From here Atmakur is around 40 kilometers, and in the forest you have seen how thick forest it is.
Interior
going
forest. Thick interior forest.
Interior forest going for higher education is not a small thing. It is a dream only, but they have successful. And I request the government of India and the tribal affairs, both the state government and the central government, to support these boys for their higher education.
Even after 65 years of independence, we are not able to provide the basic infrastructure for the vulnerable population of India. Here we can see the Chanchus, how they are suffering since last 65 years. In the name of the development, the Indira Awas program has introduced and constructed the houses. Many of the houses are not completed even after 25 years, which you can observe on the National Highway Pailudi-Gudam. This is the situation. Here, most of the houses are unoccupied because they are not yet completed. The new forest policies imposed by the state and central government and the interference of the non-tribals and officials, the Chanchus are exploited, alienated and lost control over their environment, and thereby struggling to survive. The loss of forest is posing a great problem, especially for women who take the responsibility to feed themselves and their family. The Chanchus are struggling for their survival. They lost their bamboo groves which are in the forest. The forest officials are not allowing the Chanchus to cut the bamboos and food gathering hunting. So many Chanchus lost their traditional occupation and shifted their occupation to the daily wage laborers. The Chanchus are facing a threat for their survival. They are depending on the rice and pulses supplied through the public distribution system.
Health conditions, he is the medicine man, curing different kind of ailments, diseases. As you have seen, he is curing the AIDS, he is curing white discharge, red discharge, blood cancer, different kinds of ailments with indigenous medicines he is curing for these people. And he is the greatest man who is save the life of many people, and he can able to give the medicine for fertility, and also he can able to give the medicine Viagra, that is, you know, stimulation for sex. He is having the medicines. So this rich knowledge of the medicine should be stored, should be collected from him by the Indian Council of Medical Research or the
research institutions should be collected from him. He is doing free service. Whatever the amount of money they will be giving, he will be receiving. So there is no fixed income for him. So his service should be recognized and he should be compensated. He should be given monthly salaries for his service. He is not only giving different kind of ailments, he can give the medicine for fertility also. He has cured many diseases. That is a great service he is rendering for the Chanchus. So it is requested a micro project for exclusively for the Chanchus should be developed. Then only we can save this population, otherwise we cannot save. They may extinct biologically, genetically. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. నమస్కారం అమ్మా.
నేను ఇంకేమంతా చెప్తున్నానమ్మా, రాష్ట్రపతి పదవి రిపోర్టు రాష్ట్రపతి అలా చూస్తాడా ఫిలిం అదంతా.
The Chanchu are biologically, genetically, culturally a distinct population living on the earth. It is the duty of all of us to save this aboriginal population before they extinct from the planet.
I like to thank all the forest officials who are in charge for this range office, especially the range of
Pangidi section,
Pecheru section, who helped me in documenting the ethnic vision on the Chanchus. Without their help, it will not be possible for me, especially for our friends here, who has helped me in taking to the different houses. And he is the oldest and senior most man. Section officer, his father was also worked in the forest. He is also working in the forest. Who knows about the Nallamalai Hills and also the Chanchu tribes? Now I request.